While following those finger marks, Cole started to feel something. A sense of belonging. It creeped him out. Lit up in his mind. He could understand what had been written there. It was a story meant to educate new vampires about the life and times of that blood-sucking bitch, Bloody Mary.
As I was strolling along the waterfront this evening, I was mistaken for a lady of the night by a group of three sailors. They sought to engage me, but could not agree over which one of them would get the pleasure of my company. Fortunately, I was able to play peacemaker. I assured them that if they could provide a soundproof room and a door with a sturdy lock, I would be happy to entertain all three of them. Well, this bargain was acceptable to all parties, and they were able to meet at least half my terms. The lock on the door was quite sturdy, and while some of their screams may have escaped the room, the sailors did not.
Look, man, that barbed cross is a big deal for these fingers. You got any idea where they'd hide something that valuable?
I don't know. You know what? Maybe the room where they kept Bloody Mary's corpse. I'll go check it out.
Right on. I'll meet you at the cathedral and we'll retrace your steps when you first went in.
Yeah, look, man, I appreciate the offer, but, I got this under control.
Sun's gonna come up. We got a few hours left.
It's too dangerous, see? I better go out this alone.
If you say so. Thank you.